In 1941, Henry Ford offered to build me a laboratory if I could come to Michigan and conduct some experiments for him at the Ford Motor Company. He wanted me to develop automobile parts from the crops that I had already spent 40 years researching. Ford opened the Carver Nutritional Laboratory in Dearborn, Michigan, in the Dearborn Water Works building. I accepted the offer and spent years designing automobile parts made completely out of soy fibers. I also found a potential source for rubber in a milkweed plant and worked this invention into Ford's auto parts. Ford was so impressed by these innovations that he used them on his personal automobiles. He had a deck lid made completely out of soy installed on his 1941 sedan. Many skeptics worried that soy products would prove to be less durable than steel and plastic and therefore would be unsafe for use on automobiles. To prove these arguments wrong, Ford took an axe to the soy deck lid on his 1941 sedan. When the axe bounced off without much damage to the automobile, most skeptics began to see soy as a safe alternative for automobiles. Along with the laboratory, Ford built a replica of my birthplace in Greenfield Village. Upon completion, I slept one night in the cabin. Ford and the Tuskegee Institute dedicated the George Washington Carver Museum to me on March 11, 1941. He wanted to ensure the preservation of my life's work and achievements within the history of the Institute. Soon after, I became ill and returned home to the Tuskegee Institute in Alabama. Ford, hearing of my disabilities, had an elevator installed in my apartment building so that I could more comfortably get around. Through our great friendship, Henry Ford challenged and encouraged me to further my innovations with peanuts, soybeans, sweet potatoes, and other sustainable crops by producing more industrial products. He honored my life as I hope I have honored his. During a time when racial differences hindered many relationships, personal and professional, our friendship became an example of what people can accomplish when they have an uninhibited meeting of the minds. Once when asked to conduct a joint interview with me, Ford responded to the reporter, "No, just ask Mr. Carver. He knows about me. I agree with everything he thinks, and he thinks the same way I do." George Washington Carver died at Tuskegee Institute on January 5, 1943, approximately 79 years of age.